Hello, I'm Luca Di Fiore. I'm the head of products at 888 XPG.
My name is Mark Yu, technical marketing manager at GScale.
I'm Jason, and I'm from Kingston Technology, and I'm the product manager of Kingston Fury.
I'm Justin Zhuang, come from Team Group.
My name is Maya. I'm working for FreeColor, and I'm a sales director now. I've been here like more than 12 years.
I'm Angel. I'm from Latin America, and I work for FreeColor doing the marketing or global marketing.
This is our early prototype of the Lancer RGB DDR5 CU-DIMM, which is the memory that we're launching with Arrow Lake S design. So not only this is coming in two flavors, 16 gigabyte with 8,400 and 8,600 megatransfer per second in Q4, but we're also going to have early next year versions that are going to be 8,800 and 9,066 megatransfer per second.
For Arrow Lake platform, because the additional CKD, we are launching the Trident Z5 CK series. This is with the new CKD clock driver, and that helps push the memory speed up. And we're expecting up to 9,400, DDR5 9,400. So that's something that you can expect with this new platform and CKD modules. And we're also continuing on with the UDIMM development, and that's going up to, we're expecting DDR5 8,600 as well.
To support the Intel new processor and the chipset launches, we will announce our Kingston Fury Renegade DDR5 CU-DIMM at the 8400 speed in capacity of 24 gigabyte for single and 48 gigabyte for dual channel kit of two. And we also have the white and the black color heat spreader, RGB and non-RGB options for PC users who have different PC DIY preference.
Our new memory technology is the CU-DIMM. CU-DIMM is like Denny's a CKD chip, little chip, and then it helps us more than 9,900 megahertz performance.
Xfinity that we have presented today is a faster memory overclocking speed right now. This is for Intel only, and we are happy to achieve such a high speed. And also, we are the first one in announced the CU-DIMM with RGB lights.
T-Force E-Train series, we just for highest series for overclocking. Also, we have the T-Quest Esper series. This series will implement with the CKD spec in this series also. But the spec is different. For T-Quest Esper, something like for the mainstream spec, and for the T-Force will something like a highest performance.
The introduction of 6400 DDR5 added the requirement for the integration of clock driver to the UDIMM and the SODIMM. And then we simply call it CUDIMM and CSODIMM.
One of the unique selling points of CU-DIMMs is the fact that here in the bottom of the center of the board, actually you have a clock driver or CKD chip that essentially what it does is provides timing separately from the original way to provide timing, which is pushed from the CPU into the bus and then to the memory module.
With the Trident Z5 CK, there's clock drivers built into it, and that's what allows the improvements of the memory speed beyond what we were able to do in the previous generations of Intel platforms.
For PC users, CU-DIMM actually enhance the signal integrity of memory and then also enable the exchange speed for the overclockable memory.
So this clock driver will help high frequency and make it more stable. So I think this technology will help us to implement and improve performance for the DDR5 and the future platform.
These are is really the key secret sauce that allows these type of modules to be more stable and have higher frequencies. Because at that point, you don't rely on a clock that is far away. It's really on the source directly on the board. And that also, even though it's a cost adder from a chip perspective, it actually makes the whole module cheaper to produce because there is less connections. So
So this is a really totally new thing, which is CU-DIMM. And then second is Chem2. We are preparing Chem2. Also, we are preparing our B-Color's own patented Chem2 as well, which is like there's a panel on the memory heat sink, heat spreader. So it will be a totally new thing. We already prepared the patent as well.
Customer can find in our market with the Intel Core processors, the new generation motherboards up to 9,466.
We're incredibly excited about the fact that Arrow Lake S launch will be the first processor to bring to the table the capability to ship clock time buffer memory. So that is really a very strong milestone to be able to not only provide higher frequency memory, so we're talking about the first memory modules that are going past 8,000 megatransfer per second and into the 9,000 megatransfer per second, but it's also doing it so in a more reliable and a more stable way.
So with higher memory speed, especially overclockers enthusiasts, they can push more memory bandwidths. And we're hoping with the new Intel platform, Intel CPUs, that they'll give a better experience for computing, whether it's gaming or workloads or AI workloads, that sort of thing.
Intel Core Ultra 200 series processor features an integrated NPU and capable of handling the immersive generative AI calculations. Fast DDR5 memory is the next most critical component in an AI-capable PC because the AI workload are dependent on high performance and capacity system memory.
To the user, that translates directly not only to a more immersive gaming or content creator experience, but also directly into less timing issues. For instance, we are expecting to see less trouble like blue screens decreasing and so on. So that's always a welcome story for the users.
For a PC user, mostly for the gamer or high-end PC users, they will like this technology because higher speed and higher performance will for the future application, like AI application, something like this.
People think the AI only affect the VRAM in the computer, but this is not true. If you don't have a strong memory, a strong DRAM chip, the time in training this application is slower. So with our memory, we shorten the time in develop the training and the end product. If you have a strong GPU but a slow memory, this is going to affect the timing.
I think for the AI application, I think the performance for the speed will be main keep in the 8,000, maybe to 10,000 frequency. I mean the frequency, but the capacity will going up to maybe 48 gigabyte per modules. That will be more easier for the AI application. Because right now, AI application basically ask for 16 gigabyte, but this is for the normal application. But for the higher application or multi-work, there will be need be asked for more memory capacity. So I think for the AI, I will choose the highest frequency and more capacity for this application.
In the current AI economic and media frenzy, obviously, people tend to focus very much and in a way kind of erroneously on GPUs alone, right? But the reality is that memory plays a big part of this. In fact, a lot of the heavy lifting is done through memory, especially when you look at inference type of performance. And so, for instance, for XPG workstations at Computex this year, we were showing workstation loads of just one CPU and four memory modules running entire local large language models of 70 billion parameters without anything else, just powering through getting the whole model into memory. And that really gave us enough speed to run the model pretty smoothly. So no GPU at all.
I don't have a strong GPU. this is my personal experience, and I can use the development tool right now for the AI generation because I have a good memory.
We are very excited about the new launch, and then hope the PC users could enjoy the performance brought from the combination of a new Intel CPU and new chipset motherboard and the new memory module.